We will start this service with a word of prayer this time, and Reverend Johnson Daniel will come and say a word of prayer. All the pastors who are in this sanctuary, please come. There are seats for you here.
Let's close our eyes and look to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank thee and we praise thee for this wonderful time thou hast given in our life to be in thy presence. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. What a privilege in our life to be in thy presence, O my Father. Especially in this special situation, you have been so good to us. You kept us and protect us. And this morning we have every reason to praise you and worship you and glorify your name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. When we look back, we have every reason to praise you because you have been so good to us individually, as a family, as a society. You protect us and provide us and lead us. And this morning we are gathered in thy presence to glorify your name. Especially we thank you for coming and Debbie, as they are going to be engaged this morning, Lord, I pray you may bless them in a special manner, O my Father. From the time they are born and in this world, you have been so good to them. You gave them good education, good health. As they mature, as they are planning to get into a family life, Lord, I pray them may give them wisdom, knowledge and understanding, and all the heavenly blessings upon their life. This morning we thank you for their parents and their siblings and all the pastors and all the well-wishers, those who are gathered in thy presence. Let this service be a edification in our life as well as to glorify your name. Every service, every program which is going to be held, the prayer, the documentation, the exhortation, the praise and worship, let everything be glorify your name and through our life, O Lord. We thank you for your presence in our midst because you promised that for the two or three shall gather in my name, you are now Mr. my Father. Let the power of the Holy Spirit move in a special way, even to send in your service. And we give all the glory and honor to thee. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated in the presence of the Lord with an attitude of prayer and worship. At this time, the worship team, IPC Bethel Choir, will come and sing for us.
Thank you. Thank you.
here, the families, to introduce families, to say about families, and also make the purpose of the gathering known to the people who are here, Pastor Kes Chako and Mr. Mohan Malathusheri is here. And as soon as they make that announcement, Kevin and Debbie, you can come and take the seats and we will continue with the service.
I praise and thank God for this great day. I greet you in the precious name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I thank all of you for coming together with us, even though the COVID and the weather was not suitable for us. Today, we are gathered here to sign the document of Kevin and Debbie's engagement service. We, both families, are gathered together and made certain decision about their wedding. Today, before you, we would like to sign the documents and declare the date of wedding. Let us sit in the presence of God with prayerful attitude, so that the Spirit of God may move among us and bless each one of us. May God bless us.
Pastor Jesse, Jacob, and then I'm going to give you the name. My younger brother is here, Elias Matthew, all the way from New Jersey. Please come forward to sign the documents. Please come.
And brother Envy is also, please come.
The father of the bride has spoken, and the father of the groom agreed. That's a wonderful thing to hear. They are in absolute agreement. I'm reading this wedding engagement decree, after which they will exchange the official documents, and you will take it from there. The wedding engagement decree: it is hereby solemnly resolved in the meeting of the representatives of both parties on February 13th, 2020, that the holy matrimony of Kevin Matthew, son of Mr. Mohan and Mrs. Omana Matthew, Malathusheri House, residing at 2618 Design Circle, Missouri City, Texas, 77459, with Debbie Chako, daughter of Reverend Dr. Casey Chako, and Mrs. Celine Chako, Pelimanal House, residing at 2658 Miller Ranch Road, Pearland, Texas, 77584, will, God willing, be solemnized at Hyatt Ziva, Porto Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, on June 26, 2021 at 10 a.m. In witness whereof the parties have here and to set their hands on this day and on behalf of everybody, the groom, bride, witnesses at the passage of sign, and this has become an official statement now, and the parents will exchange it. നിങ്ങൾ ചോദിച്ചാലും ചോദിച്ചില്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു കുടുക്കുകയും വാങ്ങിക്കുകയും ചെയ്തു. It seems that Pastor Casey Chacko is in a hurry to get it done. And we appreciate it. He has done a lot of work behind it, along with the father for the two. Let's one more time clap a little more time. But before we go into that, let me remind you that though this is a short service, this is not just a social gathering. This is not just a ritual. Because anyone who knows the Judeo-Christian tradition knows that it entails much more meaning than just one word, engagement. So that is why I hesitate to say this as engagement, but this is rather a betrothal for a Jew, they say it is called a rusim. And they continue to have a 1 year period of waiting for the bride to be joined to the groom. And this has deep meaning theologically, historically, ecclesiastically and eschatologically. So for the Christian people it is important, and that is why we have set apart a little time for Dr. P.B. Thomas to come and share later on, because that is not just a part of the service, but it is definitely one integral and important part, because this is the time for us to meditate upon what God is doing in our life, what tradition has gone behind it, and what is the meaning of that. Today, Debbie has been elevated from a different status. In fact, both of them have come to a place higher than they were sitting. So we are giving them all the attention, because we know that one day Christ Jesus will come back to take his bride. And for us, this is the time of the Kedushin, which is the period of waiting after the Erusin. And when you come to the Nesuvin part, I'm just saying it in the traditional way, until that time, you are preparing to receive your bride, and the bride is preparing, bride-to-be is preparing herself to come and start a life with you. And that is exactly what is happening with Christ and his church. And we will definitely come to that part when Pastor P.B. Thomas will share God's word with us. Our life on this earth is fleeting. We are puny human beings. We are surrounded by so many difficult situations, especially during this time. But in the midst of all these difficulties, we still have reasons to celebrate. Amen? God has given a lot of reasons, 1,000 reasons to thank Him. So as we continue to sit in the presence of God, let me encourage you to pour out your hearts before the Lord and make this service not just as a ritual or a dry gathering, but thanking the Lord for what He is doing in our lives, and especially during the life of our dear children. I just want to give this time to Rachel Chacko to introduce her sister and the to-be bride, and also Hannah Matthew to introduce her brother Kevin Matthew to the audience. At this time, Rachel Chacko will come.
Hello everyone. On behalf of the Chacko household, first of all, I would like to say thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy schedules to be here. Despite everything that is going on around us, we are so grateful that each of you has taken the time to be with us today to celebrate Kevin and Debbie. So I am Debbie's older sister, and what's interesting about Debbie is actually who Debbie is named after. So Debbie's namesake, obviously named Debbie, was a nurse that my dad met in the 1980s when he immigrated, and he unfortunately was hospitalized for about 16 days. And during that time, there was a nurse named Debbie that took care of him. And as most of you know, there's not too many people that my dad becomes fond of, quickly at least. But something about the nature of Debbie and how her characteristics that were shown through her quality of work found a spot in my dad's heart. And as a result, when Debbie was born, she was named after Debbie, the nurse. So it was not very surprising when Debbie decided that she wanted to pursue a career in nursing. It all was like a full circle moment. And many of those who know Debbie knows that she possesses a lot of the qualities that you and I would think of automatically when someone says the word nurse. She's extremely kind, very considerate, and extremely nurturing. I'm a PA myself, but if someone really has a medical emergency, I always call Debbie, because I can't take care of it. I don't even know the first thing about any of the medicines. And Debbie's like, oh yeah, I've had a patient like that before, and she'll go on, you know, on her little spiel. But then, one day after Debbie became a nurse and worked for several years, she called me and she said, I hate being a nurse. And I was like, Debbie, you can't just hate what you've decided to do for the rest of your life. She's like, I never want to be a bedside nurse. And I was like, well, you can't hate what you're doing, so we gotta do it something different. And she said, well, I think I want to do my master's in business and healthcare administration. And I was like, okay, I think that's a great idea. But that's not the Debbie I knew, but I, of course, did not discourage her. I said, do what you want. If you think that's what you would love to do, continue to pursue. And so in my mind, I was like, Debbie, being a manager, a leader, that's not the nurse Debbie that I know. But I have been very surprised by who Debbie has become. A funny story that happened a couple of years ago is that I work for a dermatologist. And the dermatologist happened to have a patient that in the middle of her visit received a phone call. And my friend, being the nosy dermatologist she is, looked over, you know, to see who was calling in the middle of her visit. And it said Debbie. Debbie's like, okay. So my friend looked at the patient's polo that she was wearing, and it said, like, Harris Health. And so all of a sudden, my friend thought, Debbie, could that be Debbie that we know, Rachel's sister from Harris Health, calling? She didn't say one word. The patient continued to have a conversation with this Debbie, and she was getting kind of angry, and then she put the phone down, and she's like, gosh, my manager. And my friend thought, it couldn't be our sweet Debbie. So then weeks passed, and my friend told me, hey, does Debbie work for so-and-so, or is that a colleague of hers? And I said, I'll ask. Oh, come to find out, that manager that that patient was overly upset about was my sweet nursing sister, Debbie. She had officially become a manager. People seeked her for guidance, and she definitely took her role seriously. So it's been fun to see Debbie evolve from a nurse to a manager and take care of people and be responsible. But more importantly, it's been fun to see Debbie evolve into a woman that possesses a lot of the qualities that we see in Proverbs 31. And that's what I would say I'm most proud of, to have a sister like that. And more importantly, I am happy to have another family to share Debbie with. And so we are so grateful to the Matthew family for taking her off our hands and being able to enjoy her, because we've enjoyed her for all these years and we're happy to share that with someone else. So thank you and congratulations, both of you. Hello everyone. For those of you who don't know me, I am Anna. I am the sister of the soon-to-be groom and my parents' favorite child. I'm so very happy to meet you all. I'm excited to get to know each and every one of you. Now, Kevin and I are very close. As a little sister, I've always taken my role of annoying my big brother very seriously. Kevin has always taken his role of protecting his little sister very seriously. He's always had my back through thick and thin, and then thick again, and then thin again, and then thick again. He loves our parents very deeply. He's absolutely a family man. He is caring and kind, smart and resourceful. If you're ever in a pinch, Kevin is who you call. He's even sometimes, maybe, funny, but don't tell him I said that, okay? He has always had my back. It's always been just the two of us, but now it's the three of us. Now it's my honor to introduce my best friend, my brother, and soon-to-be groom, Kevin.
having that.
This time Amy will come forward and sing a song for us.
I greet you all in the sweet and matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Priya, കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളുടെ എൻഗേജ്മെന്റിനോട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട് ഇവിടെ കടന്നു വന്നിരിക്കുന്ന എല്ലാവരെയും ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടെ സ്വാഗതം ചെയ്യുന്നു. അതോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ ദേവിയെ കുറിച്ചും കിവിനെ കുറിച്ചും പ്രിയ സഹോദരങ്ങൾ നല്ല കാര്യങ്ങൾ പറഞ്ഞു. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ അവരുടെ പേരൻസിനെ കുറിച്ച് രണ്ട് വാക്ക് ഞാൻ പറയുവാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുകയാണ്. പാസ്റ്റർ കെ സി ചാക്കോ ആൻഡ് സെലിൻ ആൻഡി, ദേ ബോത്ത് ആർ പാസ്റ്ററിംഗ് ഇൻ വേരിയസ് ചർച്ചസ് ഫോർ ലാസ്റ്റ് 40 ഇയേഴ്സ് ഇഫ് ഐ എം റൈറ്റ്, ഇൻ യുണൈറ്റഡ് സ്റ്റേറ്റ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഈവൻ ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യ. He's a fine academician. He's a founder and a director of various institutions in US and even in India. I always admire their passion and commitment, dedication for God and for the people and for the extension of kingdom of God. At the same time, മോഹൻചാലിൻ്റെയും ഓമന ആൻ്റിയെയും കുറിച്ച് രണ്ട് വാക്ക് പറയാൻ ഞാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നത്. അവരെ ഞാൻ പരിചയപ്പെടുന്ന കഴിഞ്ഞ ഒരു 8 വർഷങ്ങൾക്ക് മുമ്പായിരുന്നു. ഞങ്ങളുടെ മണ്ടയിലെ ബൈബിൾ സ്റ്റഡിയിൽ അവര് ആദ്യമായി കടന്നു വരുന്നത് ഞാൻ ഓർക്കുന്നത് 2012 ഒരു അവസാന ദിവസങ്ങളിലാണ്. പലരും ഇവിടെ ഉണ്ട് ഞങ്ങളുടെ ബൈബിൾ സ്റ്റഡിയിൽ പങ്കെടുക്കുന്നവർ. ആദ്യ ദിവസം ഈ ഭവനം കടന്നു വന്ന് പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ദൈവജനം സംസാരിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരുന്നപ്പോൾ പ്രിയ മോഹൻജാലിൻ്റെ കണ്ണിൽ കൂടെ കണ്ണുനീര് വരുന്നത് കണ്ടപ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് മനസ്സിലായി പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവ് തന്നോട് സംസാരിക്കുന്നു എന്നുള്ള ഒരു ബോധ്യം എനിക്ക് ലഭിക്കുവാനിടയായിട്ടിരുന്നു. ആ കാലഘട്ടം മുതൽ ഈ പ്രിയ ഭവനത്തിന് വേണ്ടി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുവാൻ കുടുംബമായി ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ദൈവം അവസരങ്ങളെ ഒരുക്കി തരുവാനിടയായിട്ടിരുന്നു. മോഹൻജാനെ കുറിച്ച് ഒറ്റ വാക്കിൽ ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞാൽ കർത്താവ് നദനിയലിനെ കുറിച്ച് പറഞ്ഞൊരു പദമാണ് എൻ്റെ മനസ്സിലുള്ളത്. ഇവൻ സാക്ഷാൽ ഇസ്രയേലിൻ, ഇവനിൽ കപടമില്ല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞതുപോലെ മോഹൻജാനെ അറിയാവുന്ന എല്ലാവർക്കും അറിയാം ഒരു കപടമില്ലാത്ത നിഷ്കളങ്കനായ ഒരു അനുഗ്രഹീതനായ ഒരു ക്രൈസ്തവനാണ്. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഓമന ആൻ്റിയെ കുറിച്ച് ഒരു വാക്ക് പറഞ്ഞാൽ മെനി ടൈംസ് ഓമന ആൻ്റിയുടെ ഹോസ്പിറ്റാലിറ്റി സ്വീകരിക്കുവാനുള്ള ഭാഗ്യം ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ലഭിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. ആ ഭവനത്തിൽ നിന്ന് ഓരോ പ്രാവശ്യവും ഞങ്ങൾ ഇറങ്ങുമ്പോൾ നിറഞ്ഞ മനസ്സോടും നിറഞ്ഞ സംതൃപ്തമായ വയറോടും കൂടെ ഇറങ്ങുവാൻ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഭാഗ്യം ലഭിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. അങ്ങനെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ട രണ്ട് കുടുംബത്തിലെ രണ്ട് കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾ ഇന്ന് എൻഗേജ്ഡ് ആകുന്നു എന്നുള്ളതിൽ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് വലിയ സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്. നിങ്ങളെ ഓർത്ത് ഞങ്ങൾ വീണ്ടും പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കും. കുടുംബമായി ഓൺ ബിഹാഫ് ഓഫ് മൈ ഫാമിലി വൺസ് അഗെയിൻ വി എക്സ്പ്രസ് അവർ ജോയ് ആൻഡ് കൺഗ്രാറ്റുലേഷൻ ഫോർ ദിസ് മൂമെന്റ് ആൻഡ് ഫോർ അപ്കമിംഗ് മാരേജ്. Before I finish, let me read a passage from Numbers chapter 6, verse number 24 to 26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you shalom. Thank you.
Reverend Dr. Sally Daniel will come forward and will say a word of blessing and a prayer for the children, which will be followed by a word of sharing by Dr. T. B. Thomas from Rosewood.
Shall you close our eyes for prayer? Ask God's blessing upon our dear children. I want everyone to join in this prayer as we seek God's face. My dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your presence here this morning. A God that is with a joyful heart, with an attitude of gratitude, we come to your presence for everything that you do in us and through us, O God. And this morning we want to thank you for blessing this service and this point. And we know that you are going to continue to bless us throughout this service, O God. This morning especially we want to thank you for Kevin and David. O God, we bring them unto thy presence. We thank you that they were able to declare their commitment to one another, the promise to marry in this service, O God. We pray that you continue to bless them, O God, as they publicly declared their commitment to marry. They promised to Mary, we together ask for your abundant blessing upon them, O Master. Father, from today on, as they prepare for their wedding, may your Holy Spirit guide their steps. In every plan they make, I pray that may your wisdom and your grace be upon them, O God. Grant them your kindness. God, we pray that always cover them under your mercy and faithfulness, O God, Jesus. But let them be united for your glory, to bring glory to your kingdom, O Master. Father, we also realize this wedding engagement service is a declaration, is a representation of our commitment with Christ. The covenant that your Son, the covenant between your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the church. God, this time we pray that everyone who witnessed this service may prepare our own hearts for your soon coming, O God, Jesus. Father, prepare ourselves for the soon coming wedding of the Lamb, for which we all look forward. God, may your Holy Spirit prepare our hearts towards that, O Master. God, once again, we want to thank you for Pastor Casey Chadwell and his family, and also Matthew's family. I pray that you bless both the families, because the wedding is not only between the individuals, but also it is a connection between the families. I pray that you bless them, O God. Thank you for their heart to serve you and to bring their life that brings glory to your kingdom, O Master. We once again want to thank you for everyone who gathered here, as we now spend a few minutes to listen to your voice through your servant. I pray that you anoint Pastor P.B. Thomas to bring your word to us, O Master. Thank you, and we give you all glory, honor, and praise and dominion. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Bailey and Kevin, all of you, greetings. I know at least some of you might wonder why I stand here. Last night, when we arrived from Dallas, Debbie was at her parents' home, and Kevin too. And sometime during the conversation, Debbie listed all the close friends of her parents, her dad very special. And I was very happy to hear my name in the list. I am very, very happy to be part of Debbie's engagement, the Indian engagement. We all know what I mean. Well, I was very happy to be present at Debbie's parents' engagement in 1984. If you know the geography of Kerala, in a remote village near the town city of Palakkad, Prabhakar, where only a few of us were present, Selin was not present. Debbie's dad was present, and Debbie's grandfather, Appachan, cooked all the meal because Amaji was in Philadelphia. Those days, like this, they didn't sit. That day when I was waiting with some others in the railway station at Palakkad, Selin came by train. On her way, I believe it was to Bombay. And it is no coincidence that the sari that Selin wore that day and the color of the sari that she is wearing today matters. I'm not joking. I sat here and recollected. That was the first time I was seeing Selim. I didn't meet. The train stopped only 2 minutes. We said hi, but we knew each other quite well by then. Friendship, it's precious. People often ask how you and Pastor Chaco know each other. Well, or since when? We met together in a very small Bible training institute in Kerala, at Mavelikku, in 1980. Then he came to the US in 1984. I stayed on there 2 more years. But the years when we were together, preaching God's word, teaching God's word, training young men, so many of our students are here. Pastor Shadi is my student. Elias, he studied Akhilas studied in the school where I was a teacher. I didn't think I taught him. But for all of them, we thank God. But we started it together in a very small Bible Institute in Mavelikkara. And I am so grateful for my friendship with Pastor Chaco, Selim, and through them, the extended family, so many are here. They always treat me as one in the family, blood related. For my education, for my ministry, particularly here in this country, I owe the most to my friendship with Pastor Kesi Chaco. It has been my joy to watch these two girls grow up. It was in the early 90s I came to this country. And within a couple of days after landing in New York, I ended up in their home. Memories of Debbie, only a few. But my memory, she was very young, I believe barely 2 by then. She would sit on the top of the stairs and then slide down effortlessly with so much ease, never making a mistake. Then what Debbie did, you know, when she was very young, you would see her with one cloth, this minute, next minute, another one. She'll remove everything, throw everywhere. She knew how to pick up and put on the new one. I don't know how many in a day she bought. Those are just 2 memories. But I remember one of those days, we all went walking to the school ground near their home. And Rachel, I don't know if she was 3 or so, she said, "Angel, Suchikane, Veera, Satira." I was so surprised with that word, Satira. You know, picking up such a difficult word. But I thank God for the way in which God has preserved this family, Rachel and Debbie, for the great education God has given them, the professional attainment that they have achieved thus far, and for the great achievement that is still awaiting. So many more years to go. Last night was the first time I met Kevin. I told myself, "Oh, the right guy for Debbie." Truly, after they left, I shared the same thing with Pastor Chaco and Selim. Now I know it is well past 12 o'clock. Oh no, it's still, it's not at 12 o'clock. In 2 minutes, 12 o'clock. I don't really know whether your appetite is for preaching from a preacher like me or for food. But, you know, Pastor Abraham Chaco made it abundantly clear that among us, nothing happens without preaching. Well, briefly meditating God's word. Moments like this, hearing what the Bible says is important to us. Recalling what God has revealed, spoken through His servants generations ago,
for his people for generations to come. That is so important to all of us. And I ask you to be patient with me for a few minutes as I share with you a few thoughts from God's Word. We already used the word bride and bridegroom. And June 22nd, we would use the word husband and wife. I will take the freedom to use husband and wife language a little bit today as I talk to you. In the New Testament, our relationship with Jesus Christ is pictured, explained using different imageries, different pictures. One is the body language. Christ being the head, and we all together being the body of Christ. Another picture is the big picture of a building. Christ being the cornerstone, the apostles and the other ministers being the foundation stones. All of us living stones continually being built in by God, you know, until God finishes the work. We have the image of vine and the branches. Now another very popular image is the image of husband and wife, bride and bridegroom. That's an image that is relevant to us at this hour as we are here, in an engagement service. Pastor Abraham Jack already repeatedly used the word betrothal. I'll come to that very soon. Let me start with the image of marriage, husband and wife. You have it so well explained, narrated by Paul as he writes to the church in Ephesus, and through that letter to all of us, all generations to come. And it is found in Ephesians chapter 5. Oftentimes, for all wedding services, we refer to it. I am, for the first time in an engagement service, referring to it. I simply want to talk a little bit about our relationship with Jesus Christ, his relationship with us. The picture of husband and wife, man and woman, and here, Jesus Christ and the people of God. Jesus Christ and his church. Jesus Christ and all of us. Jesus Christ having the picture of a husband, and the people of God, his people, all of us, the picture of a wife. And this is what the scripture writes. It is calling out to the husbands to love their wives. And then suddenly, Paul the writer uses the image. As Christ loved the church, gave himself up for her. I mean, church, he thinks about people. And says, Christ gave himself up for his people. Well, he has a purpose. I'll come to that. But let me dwell on the word. The words gave himself up. Keep that in your mind. Christ gave himself up for his people. I mean, for the wedding. Maybe the preacher will use this passage again. And then will encourage Kevin that he must be ready to give himself up. Okay. When I counsel young people who are getting ready to be married, I tell them that the Bible is more harsh on the man because his call is to die for his wife. The wife is simply called to follow the husband, submit to husband, just respect, take the commands from the from there. But the man is called to die. Anyway, and here is the source where it says Christ gave himself up for his people. Now Paul, as he writes this letter from a prison in Rome, he also wrote another letter to another church in Philippi. In chapter 2 of that letter, this is what Paul writes there. And he writes to all of us too. He says, God, Jesus Christ, being equal with God the Father, in his glory, in his knowledge, in his power, In his everything that is of God, here is the word he uses. He emptied himself and became a man. So Jesus, the Son of God, eternal one, emptied himself, meaning that he set aside all his divine privileges or rights, power for our sake. He became a man. And then he says what he did eventually there in that passage. And so these two words, be right deep down in your hearts, that Jesus Christ, for us, for his people, one, emptied himself, two, gave himself up. We know what I am referring to. He gave himself up in the sense that, you know, he lived among us, he became a man. You know, he took human flesh in the womb of a virgin called Mary from Nazareth. And he took birth into this world, grew among us, became mature, became a man. And then in his time, in the fullness of God's time, gave himself to be crucified. The Jews did not kill Jesus. Pilate did not kill Jesus. We don't feel angry with those people. Jesus simply traveled to Jerusalem during that Passover to give himself to be crucified on that cross. If he had not given himself up to be arrested and then to be nailed to the cross, no one could touch him. Judas knew that well, in the sense that people couldn't do anything against Jesus. But Jesus walked down, or traveled on the donkey. He went to Jerusalem to give himself to be crucified. And we know where that ended. He gave himself willingly to be nailed on the cross. As they were nailing him, he cried and said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." The Roman soldiers who nailed Jesus Christ, for whom Jesus prayed, because they did not know what they were doing. He was dying. He was giving himself. He was just giving himself to die like the kernel of a wheat, who would fall on the ground and die and be no more, so that countless other seeds will germinate and grow. That was the reason. And here it says, Jesus gave himself up for his people, for us. Why? That he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word. I mean, you know, I don't want to dwell too much there, but why did he do that? He did that because he might sanctify all who would believe in Jesus Christ. He would sanctify each one of us. I mean, why is sanctification necessary? Because I was lost. And we were born in sin. In the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve rebelled against the Creator. They rejected the authority of God, and we were lost. Satan became our master. He had the right to place his yoke on us, and we were bound by sin, and we were lost to God. We were lost in miry clay, to use the Bible language, the language of the psalmist. But Jesus came down, gave himself up on the cross, so that through his death, our sins would be covered, and God would overlook our failings. And so that you and I would have the feeling that we are the people of God. To use the Bible language that is relevant for this hour, we would feel that we are the bride of Jesus Christ. Amen. And he gave himself up to make us his bride. He has just one bride. We are under different labels, different traditions, different structures. But Jesus Christ, as one bride, all the people of God, drawn from all ages, from all languages, from all backgrounds, and following Jesus Christ, and he calls all of us his bride. What is the ultimate goal at the end? So that he might present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle, or any such thing, so that she might be holy and without blemish. He has an ultimate purpose for giving himself up, for dying on the cross, so that we will be redeemed, brought out from that which is unclean, and he would cleanse us. He would cover us with his righteousness, and he would, at the end, present us in the presence of God, holy, amen, without blemish. That is His purpose. Now, you be us all very happy for what is happening in the life of Debbie and Kevin, for what is happening in the Chaco family, what's happening in the Matthew family. But during this moment of this joy, let's reflect on our own lives. Amen. Think about Jesus Christ, our Savior, who became, he became a sacrifice for us, a husband for eternity. And ask ourselves, am I so sure that I am cleansed, that my sins are forgiven, that He has covered my sins with His blood, that there is a covering of the blood of Jesus Christ on my life? Do I feel that I am among the bride of Jesus Christ? The other picture, I know too long I'm talking, the other picture very briefly, then I will close. The other picture in the Bible is the picture of the betrothed. It is quite unlike American engagement. It's quite unlike the Indian engagement, but very close to the Indian engagement. The betrothal in the Bible culture is something that you cannot very easily break. You cannot walk out of it. There is, you know, society places a lot of legal binding on it. Legal, not in the sense in which we live today, but in the sense in which people lived at that time. Paul takes that as he writes to another church and to all of us, and he says that I have betrothed you to Jesus Christ. I will read a verse. I feel a divine jealousy for you, since I betrothed you to one husband to present you as a pure virgin to Christ. But I am afraid that as a serpent delivered Eve by his cunning, your thoughts will be led astray from a sincere and pure devotion to Christ. Two words I emphasize: sincere and pure. And the most important, those are adjectives. Devotion. Devotion to Christ. Sincere and pure devotion to Christ. Here the picture is that, you know, we have been betrothed as a people, all of us together, one church, all who are devoted to Jesus Christ. To use another language of the Bible, all whom God worked in their hearts and made them new beings in Jesus Christ. Amen. That is our life in the presence of God. God has made us new people because of our faith in Jesus Christ. And we are betrothed to a bride, a husband who is to come from the heavens in the clouds when the trumpet sounds. And Paul is telling that his people should then follow a life of sincere and pure devotion and should not defile themselves. Now look at these two pictures. Pictures of marriage in Ephesians, picture of marriage in Corinthians. Betrothal in Corinthians. Betrothal. In one, Jesus gave himself to make us holy in his presence, paying the price, becoming a sacrifice. Amen. So that he will present us in his presence. In the other picture of betrothal, Jesus Christ, in the picture of the betrothal, we are called to do something. I know Debbie knew Kevin months ago, maybe. I haven't investigated, but I am guessing months at least. They have been getting to know each other, but they have been watching each other so well, how devoted to each other they are. How good a life that each one leads. There is a purity of life that is expected. There is an amount of devotion that is expected. Similarly, they will continue to be so all their life. Similarly, remember always, in the presence of God, that God expects through Jesus Christ that we would all lead a life which is a life of sincere and pure devotion to Jesus Christ. This is a moment to ask ourselves about our lives. We are so happy for our children. we are committing to them in the presence of God, then more so we will pray for them, for the months ahead until marriage, and for their life together, as long as God would keep them alive and well and together. But let's also ask ourselves, how pure and sincere devotion do I have to Jesus Christ, who gave himself up, emptying his divine rights and powers, and coming for me, dying on the cross. How much am I devoted? Just as I congratulate Debbie and Kevin, and commit to pray for them, I also ask you to please ask this question in the presence of God, and I ask you to be determined to lead a life that is pleasing to Jesus Christ. Knowing so well that Jesus died on the cross for me, and therefore I should lead a life that is pure and sincere, so purely devoted to Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless all of you with these words, the words of God.
Thank you, Pastor P.P. Thomas. In a few moments, we will wind this up to switch to a lighter note. It is time for us to interview families, and I will be calling the concerned people. But before that, let me tell you that this is the first time I'm meeting the Mohan family. But to remind you that in the first century, 72 of our families traveled together. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Pastor P.P. Thomas, as far as my memory goes back, he has never spared an opportunity to put my legs when we talk about this. And Pastor P.P. Thomas has always joined as a partner in the crime. So this is positively, but saying that, our families travel together, about 72 families. But by some providence, God has actually closed the mouth of the lion, and Mohan will have some fun time in the coming days. So enjoy with him in that. So we thank God for the opportunity. At this time, Brother Mr. Mohan Matthew and Pastor K.C. Thakur will come forward, and they will introduce their respective families, which will be followed by a word of thanks by Lalu Abraham, and prayer and benediction by Dr. Johnson Thomas. Pastor K.C. Thakur and Mr. Mohan, please come forward and introduce your families.
Hello everybody, I'm Kevin's dad, myself Mohan Matthew, and my wife is here, Rauli Omra, and my daughter Hannah, and my younger brother came all the way from New Jersey, yes Matthew, but we call him Moti, what a Hindi Moti. But is my nephew is here, Mr. Raju and Emily Chirmarumbil. Although he is my nephew, he is older than me. Thank you. And my wife's sister, Chinnamal. My daughter, Tara. Binu, husband, and two kids, Amy and and what is
it?
Yeah, all of us on this floor, I think all of my friends and relatives in this seats here. I'm not telling you his name because it's going to be too long. And that's it. And welcome our new daughter, Debbie, to Matthew family. And thank you for coming out, all of you, to celebrate Kevin and Debbie's engagement. Thanks.
It's a
again I praise and thank God for this day. God brought us to this to rejoice with the dear ones and close ones. See, I have a big family, and Celine also has a big family. And I have COVID in the Russian world. I had never known it. And he came to brothers in Celine, Umbadu brothers. Who have a language of Nabala, Matu, and Angra, Umbada, Celine, Umbada. And Jan, Woody, Pinna, and he came to our Adin cousins on that. Our COVID island, Kalas, the most island, Kanaman, Tilla, other questionary group. Coming from the moon and Vega, and who were that very much from Paravan and Agri, and the Paria, Selinu, and the Magala, Rachel, and whatever. Adugada, Selinde, Anna, Mare, Renduveru, other Manu, Susan, Shadu, Shadu, and the Magal, Abelu, Leather Pierce in the Malak, Mosamai, Galas, the Aitu, Avicanolu, very often, and they were studying. Adugada, and the brother, Casey Abraham, Paria, Alisum, whatever. Awe orang dengan tujuh tahun studi kita, malah kerja pertama ni dia awalnya orang itu travel itu orang ni, ini muka dia sendiri. Macam itu lagi, dengan ini muka macam syari, purbo, buleh orang ni. Aduh, orang ada, yang de, acah ini, dia sendiri maklai, kalau itu ini nanti orang ni, adil ni, ini khasin macam itu lagi, ama ama, panca, raja mami, makan jojo ini, purbo, buleh, orang orang tua ini kita, kucing orang purbo, buleh ayam kita, hari orang ni, tujuh tahun studi kita. Orang ini amma ibu dia jasad tiada, makanan makan, binodam, pura boleh beri ayat. Tapi peranan media family ayat orang ada, baki church family ayat ni ke itu special. Kene pada ni tahun terwise ni, ni ambil duit ter, baki school itu pelajar, budesi ayat. Pada ni pertama tu, saya agaknya rumah, Kashmir itu kucu church ni pas payah. Anu udah Hindu hari ni pas payah. Orang ni keluar, ini believers ayat family orang ada. Orang dengan kerana orang itu nak, semua orang yang dia itu studi dulu, dengan beberapa perasaan mereka macam jadi dulu, sama yang korang dulu mana, yang ada baki orang dulu parent orang bantu tapi ni pernah tidak, dengan semua orang yang dia ikut, dengan kerana orang dengan orang yang dia orang macam itu, dengan itu nanti orang itu, semua orang kaya dia itu studi dulu.
A word of thanks by Mr. Lalu Abraham.
Praise the Lord, and good afternoon to everybody. My name is Lalu. I'm one of the 7 and it's from God's side. My assignment is to briefly say the words of thanks to everyone who made today's engagement possible. First of all, I thank God for leading Kevin and Debbie to each other and for his presence, grace, and mercy in allowing us today to conduct the engagement service between them. I wish and pray that the Lord may continue to bless them in the coming days. Next, we want to thank the pastor and the board of directors of Living Water Christian Church for allowing us to use their church facility, and especially Pastor Abraham Chacko for leading the event. We also want to thank Pastor Johnson Daniel for leading us in prayer. A sincere thanks to Bethel Church Choir for uplifting us by singing spiritual songs. Thank Brother Pastor Akula Abraham for the encouraging felicitation, and Amy Chandy for singing the melodious song. A special thanks to Pastor P.D. Thomas for bringing us the message from the Word of God, and to Dr. Shaila Daniel for blessing the couple. A sincere thanks to all of the ministers and to relatives and friends who came from far and near to attend the engagement service, making it a blessing for us. Also, we thank the volunteers and believers of the LIPC Church for attending to various details related to today's function. We thank Siva Restaurant in Houston for providing excellent catering service. If I miss anyone, please accept our hearty thanks to all of you. May God continue to bless us.
Let's all close our eyes and look into the Lord. Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you, Lord, for this beautiful, beautiful time. The time that we could all come together in your name, O God, in this sanctuary,
in this place for this beautiful engagement service of God. Thank you, Lord, for bringing us together. You are in the presence, your presence was here, O Lord, and thank you, Lord, for helping us to celebrate this, to acknowledge your presence, O God, and to hear from thy word one more time to dedicate our life, Lord, to the one who has called us and redeemed us and who gave himself up to redeem us. O God, thank you, Lord, for your grace and your love towards us, and thank you for reminding us through the servant of God who shared the word. And we pray for both the families, Pastor Chaco family and the Matthew families, O God, that their friends and families all together, we could come together and celebrate this at this time. I pray for Kevin and Debbie especially, Lord, as they are planning the details of their wedding, O God, and may the Lord, good God, guide them and guard them and give them wisdom and knowledge as they have taken this commitment to move forward, to go forward, O God. And we pray for special provisions over them, O God, and as both families are involved and making decisions, O God, we once again thank you, Lord, in the midst of all this pandemic and weather situations and things like that. Lord, thank you for bringing us together, O God. We have only one thing to say, O God. You saved us. You redeemed us, O God. May the seed of the word of God that we heard today, it's going to sprout. It's going to produce more and more abundant harvest in the days to come in all of our lives, O God. One more time, we thank God for Pastor Abraham Checo, who's leading who led this the service and the beautiful worship songs and everything, oh God. We dedicate our life one more time and bless these families. In Jesus' name we pray. God, thank you. Let's go with the benediction. Also, we pray for the food that has been prepared. Lord, thank you, Lord, one more time. We thank and praise you. Thank you for the food that has been prepared for us. And Lord, bless it and help us to have it for your glory and honor. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us, especially with Kevin and Debbie, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Bless you.
We thank God for allowing blessing upon us by God, and together we join our hearts in thanking the Lord. I also want to personally thank all of you for your kind cooperation. At this time, Mr. Jacob Titus will come forward and let you know about the arrangements.
Congrats, Debbie and Kevin. It's gorgeous. Made for each other. Lunch it will be served, it's perfect. And this side, last table, go first. There are ushers, they will help me to lead. And please, humbly requesting, come back to the table. Considering the COVID, don't spend the groups. Thank you so much.
You're releasing the gentle in the tables? Yeah. The volunteers, the ushers, they will come to your table and they will release you to go and take from the buffet. Right? You're ready?
Yeah.
So please be seated until they come and ask at each table to go and take from.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Yeah, nice fight.